Last one and a half years, we have been seeing a pandemic in the world, and then children are not able to go to school and are at home and going through live sessions, and they have lost their regular education system which they were undergoing. So is this a time for us to look for an alternative system? Do children will have to go through the same home online classes, because this pandemic is going to continue for maybe another 1 year, and we don't know in future what sort of pandemics will keep coming.
So we know that childhood is very important in channelizing the energies in a specific direction, and education plays a very important role. But in present situation, too much focus and worry about career, not only by child, from the parent side, putting lot of pressure on students. It is creating lot of personality problems. Forget about career and settlement in life. That is very important, but not the end of the game.
Now, this academic year 2021-22, we are planning to start a new Gurukul under a new format, which will go through NIOS recognition for the 10th exams.
So studying or learning, it should go in a happy state and with contented state. We know that our basic Indian traditional system of learning is not a stress creating, it is actually stress relieving.
This Rishi Vatika Gurukulam was started in 2015 with a small batch of rural children at Rishi Vatika, which is about 150 kilometers from Bangalore. And this was inspired by our Guruji Dr. Vedavyasji's book, which was written on national education, and he promoted Gurukula style of education. As he himself has never gone to a school, and he studied at his home under his father, and then later he wrote his intermediate exam from Banaras and then went to IAS, and then he served as IAS officer in the country.
A balanced personality, contentment, happiness, these are all possible when they learn the things in a comfortable situation, enjoying the nature with a specific, not a stipulated fixed timings, at different timings, and staying in close contact with the gurus. That is our Gurukul concept, basic, our ancient learning processes like that. So that type of learning is the need of the hour.
Rishi Vatika is a place which is where University of Vedic Sciences, which also has got the Gurukul school.
And also this Gurukulam is inspired by a national education book written by Sri Aurobindo and Swami Vivekananda, who have given a detailed account of how the schooling should be for a child. India is rapidly going through a change in the economy, in the IT industry, and world over, there is a requirement that the future is going to be artificial intelligence, machine learning, and these kind of technologies are going to boom. And then India has to be in the forefront. We lost our major IT growth, or we could not build any products based industry in India, though we were all into services. So with this idea, whether we can build our next generation to build enterprises and become entrepreneurs, build products and make India a future ready country. And we are one of the youngest population. Our population is the youngest and we have a great opportunity. So in the current education curriculum, we have to complete engineering, which takes almost 18-20 years for a person to complete, and then even then he is not ready for a good software job. He has to undergo some kind of a training outside. So why not we cut down this? Do we really need 18 years of education to become a software engineer? Or do we really need 18 years to learn any of these skills which are required to make him get into a better career? Now, top companies like Microsoft, Facebook, and are not looking at engineering graduates. They are willing to pick up 10th and 12th grade students if they are able to write good algorithms and good, they have good logic. So why not we build this from the start of a child? With this idea, we thought we'll start a Gurukulam which will focus on software skills and IT for the IT industry in the future. Our curriculum, the way we have designed, is we'll have mathematics, we'll have statistics, we'll have logic, and we'll use Nyaya Shastra to give them better logic understanding. And then apart from that, we'll have Sanskrit as our main language. And campus, we want children to speak only in Sanskrit. Sanskrit is going to be a future computational language, which a lot of companies have already started investing in Sanskrit scholars, as Sanskrit will become a future language for software. Infrastructures we are already built. We have a Goshala, we do regular Yajnas, we have a Yajnashala. Prayogshala, we have a small laboratory where students at the very young age should start using this lab to really understand the physics and chemistry kind of aspects of life. And then we have Dharmashala, where people from outside can come, stay, and also interact with students and then enhance their skills. Apart from this, we have Panchamukhi education system where we teach Vedas. Vedas, not in literally sense the Vedic chanting, but all our Shastras from Itihasas like Ramayana, Mahabharata, and Sanskrit itself, and which in future they'll have better understanding of our Vedic sciences. Apart from that, we'll have regular sciences like maths, physics, chemistry, and also on the Vedic part of Vedic Ganita, higher level of mathematics, of algorithms and algebra, whatever Vedic Ganita teaches. And then we have Krishi in the sense people have to work hard. So they'll have agriculture, and then they'll also have to do selfless service, which was very important aspect of their personality development. And we'll have martial arts and other arts which physically make them fit. Panchamukhi is basically Veda, Vijnana, Yoga, Krishi, and then Kala. So these five aspects we have to cover. The admission is for the children who have 10 years of age, or up to 12 years, anywhere between 10 to 12 years we can take them in. And then up to 16 years of age they'll stay in this Gurukula system. And then also this is the most important period of a child where the learning is maximum.
Our national heritage begins with the Vedas, and it should have been heralded a resurgence with our country's independence. Sri Aurobindo, on whose birthday our country attained independence, dreamed of national education. By national education, he meant our own education, not foreign education. And before long, if we don't restore back our national heritage, we will be all duplicate prints of George Bush or Mao Zedong or anybody else other than Indians. So our cultural freedom begins with the liberation of our education. I considered it as my God-given duty. And whatever privileges God has given as Gurukula education in my childhood, Vedic education in my middle age, and a degree in modern science in my 20s, I was a professor in Dayala at 21 because of the Gayatri Mantra. When a professor in Harvard asked me, what is the difference between Eastern education and your so-called Gurukula education? I told him, modern Western education is about transferring information from outside into the mind of the student. Ancient education is about taking out knowledge from your soul.